Howdy. Welcome to another Teletran 3 review with RuneScape 2-8 and...
Silverbolt here, joining RuneScape for this video on animated soundwave.
First, the aesthetics. Both modes have the same general colour scheme, which is faithful to G1 soundwave, except for that somewhat ugly turquoise. At least some of it is decoed to look like cassette tape sprockets. I also like the way the grille resembles a CD player's controls, and how there's a power-up button on top. The vehicle's proportions are pretty good, and there are no obvious robot extras, even from underneath. The robot's proportions are pretty squat, which give it some character. And of course, he has the classic G1 cassette chest. I don't know if anyone else thinks this, but the shoulders look a bit like speakers, what with the wheels in the middle. Finally, there's the head sculpt, which is very show accurate.
Okay, onto the articulation of this toy. Starting at the bottom, his feet, though I think this is actually due to his transformation technique, but his feet will move down. They are connected by a pin joint at the ankle. He bends at the knees, so, and it moves back like that, roughly 45 degree angle. I do have noticed on this toy though that the knee is very weak, and he has a habit of doing that. Okay, hip sockets, and the legs will move out like that, kung fu kick, and they'll also move forwards and backwards. Because of his transformation technique, he also has articulation at the waist, so he will turn at the waist. At the shoulder, the shoulders will move very slightly up, but not really by an awful lot, without forcing it into a weird angle. Shoulder joints will, of course, rotate. Kind of. There we go. Shoulder joints will rotate 360 degrees. Forearms are on a hinge like that, so they'll move up and down. The hands, due to transformation technique, I still feel, will flip like that, and that's the most you'll get out of them. And the head, let's get it into the light, will turn. It'll turn left and right, but it won't look up. That's the articulation for animated soundwave. Okay, now soundwave comes with one accessory in the form of Laserbeak, which as you can see can be held, kind of, in soundwave's hands. Now, Laserbeak has been modelled in what I'm assuming is the shape of a flying V guitar. And I will admit, I mean a very extreme flying V, but a flying V nonetheless, I will admit, if I had the money, I'd get one of these made, but as soon as I don't play guitar, I'd turn it into a bass. But there we go. But anyway, transforming it, push this in like that, and then just fold the two wings out, being very careful that you don't push it too far back, because that happens. That actually happened to me the first time I transformed it, understandably. However, on Soundwave's wrist, where you can see the stereo icons, there is a slot where you can push Laserbeak into, and he sits on Soundwave's arm. Laserbeak wasn't in the cartoon, but I have heard rumours that he shall be in Series 3. So there we go.
To sum it up, animated Soundwave's a nice update to a classic G1 character. He's very show accurate in both modes and is a good toy in his own right. For problems, I've already said the turquoise paint apps look bad. There's also the shoulders, which can't actually be raised without popping off or pushing the head up, like so. The knee joints are also pretty floppy, but that's easily fixable. Pop the lower legs off, apply superglue to the knee joints, leave it to dry, then pop the legs back on, and they should be stiffer. Laserbeak himself could use a few more paint apps, especially on his head, but he's still a fun accessory. Overall, I give them 4 out of 5.
Okay, my final verdict on this toy. I don't dislike it that much. I think its biggest letdown is the head. Whilst the head is show accurate, it does look like someone's walked up to me with a very large iron and gone BAM! A few times, because it's just... that's really my only gripe with it. The knees are a little bit of a problem, it has to be said, but you know, you can work round that. The other thing about this toy is it looks kind of like a fantasy dwarf, because it's got that short, squat, hurr look. I mean, I'd call him a dwarf, but he's missing a beard, so I guess that makes him a girl dwarf. It is a nice toy. Apart from really the head is my only gripe with it. Its real saving grace is Laserbeak. I think Laserbeak is lovely. I really do. Bad wing popping off and everything. The only thing I can say about it is it could have done with a little bit more design gone into the toy itself. It's just black and red. I mean, they could have painted the eyes at least. I mean, I might paint the eyes myself. To get my paintbrush. Currently painting me toes, I might be going paintbrush. But don't prevaricate on these videos. Right, but yes, I do think that the Soundwave accessory of Laserbeak is really its saving grace. But my final verdict on the toy, I'll be generous, and Laserbeak gets 2 points all on his own, and I'll give it a 4 out of 5. For now, this is Silverbolt with Animated Soundwave. Sayonara, adios, avidite.
This is RuneScape 228, signing off. Until the next review...
We will...